man is preposterous, okay? And essentially, if you sit back and say, well, so he is, what are we going to do with him? We can't do a fucking thing. And so history moves to that point where people undergo that change. Like, let me say it another way. The sailboat will come when it comes. You know what I'm talking about? A lot of people rowing a boat. Just, how long are they going to row? Have you any other suggestions? No. Well, keep rowing. While you're in a rowboat culture, instead of saying, don't people realize they're driving themselves to nuclear war? And your mother may say yes, it's true, but she has no investment in American Radium Corporation. She doesn't own any sophisticated metal plants, you know, where she sells space-age metal, so she doesn't give a shit. Stop making the weapons and all. But if your grandfather dies and leaves her a half interest in titanium, then she says, where is titanium used? On submarines, space vehicles. When is the next space program coming up? Because she's involved. And that's why I mentioned that students are pretty good, because they don't have any investment when they go to school. Stop the war now! But once they get out of school, they work for a law firm, Titanium Incorporated, American Titanium Corporation, Dow Chemical. They now have a vested interest. They have a home and a car and a kid going to school, a community, they belong to the Elks, they appear before people. So all of those things reinforce their existence. The things I teach take away from your life. Everything I teach here takes things away from you in the normal world. It makes it tougher to get along with people. It makes your income lower. It makes you more disagreeable. There's not a fucking commodity that I have to sell here that's any good. And people wonder why this system isn't successful. It's not selling anything. Once somebody said to me, what is social engineering? I said, it's a non-profit organization. They said, who's the president? I said, I am. I said, it's a non-profit. The whole idea is that if you want to make money, there are books like How to Win Friends and Influence People, How to Get Along with the Joneses. If you want to do that, that's another package. We call that living a lie, where you smile on the outside and ulcerate on the inside. Where you have palpitations and temple beating, but you get it, you smile. Anyway, when you go to the right schools, when you live with the Bentleys of Long Island, and they send you to finishing school as a little girl, you might be at a party and your husband might tip over a bowl and you might smile. Then when you get home, you chew it. So what happens? Unsophisticated people, they bowl each other out. You know, you go to a Greek party, you go to a Syrian party or a Turkish party, and there's a stupid, you do this in his house? That's not the nice. They bore you right out there. And he says, sure, that's not the nice. What do you do? But sophisticated people smile. And they always, if your wife trips or her drawers are off, you pick up her cheek and walk out, and then you beat her up. But what happens is, normal people think everyone gets along so well. Why can't you be like that? See, they turn to their wife and say, see that couple always smiling, come in with their arms around. They get along so well. Whereas root people down to earth, you know, they manifest their anger right away. They have less ulcers. But the finishing school people have lots of ulcers and psychological problems. You see? So you gotta understand what we need is not to go to finishing school and not to be so simple as to bawl people out in the presence of others. What we have to attain is a point of view that doesn't lead to the bawling out. You know what that means? That means you give somebody something that they think they want, they try to assemble it, it's beyond their experience. Instead of saying, I got you, somebody can't even put it together. You dope, I should have given it to your older brother. This is the normal world. So what you do, you give them something and say, if you have difficulty assembling it, I'll assist you in whatever way I can, if I'm able to. And if they can't put it together, that there's no use buying anything for you. You just don't have the ability. They don't conclude. You do it, you act that way. Now, you will look strange as a teacher if you did that. If you always were objective, meaning if you always act on behalf of that person, that is love. Let me say it again. You love the students that you work with, and you're bound to hurt them, like I said yesterday. You hurt people because whenever you instruct people, in the beginning, they don't come up to the levels of instruction that they might think they're at. So if I walk over somewhere and say, well, your vanishing points are too close. Now that's always associated with criticism. Your light and shade is too abrupt. Well, that's not criticism. That is Then I'll even take a pencil and show you how to attain that effect, or try to. But it's not criticism. It is a clarification of insufficiency. That's quite different. Now, criticism is something like this. I took her skating, she fell 9 times, embarrassed me in the ring. That's sick. It's not even criticism, it is sick. So there's no sense for us to point at people and say, boy, did she do a stupid thing Wednesday? Of all the dopes, there's a prize dope. Now, you got to understand, the person making this announcement has a low self-sufficiency, and he climbs up on your back. That's the way he gets his own sufficiency. On your back. He who's laughing is the biggest dope, and he climbs on his back. You see? So there are people that have no existence, and they must then feel sorry for them. And not only that, the very interesting thing to do sometimes, if you do it right, is when a person starts on you. Do you mind if I use you?
No.
That they start on you. And then you say, not only that, I failed 6 times in the 3rd grade. And you go on, you keep, and then you go on and you name all the other things that you did. None of you're not that bad. You ain't heard half of it. And you go on, elaborate. Sometimes they might get the message. But the idea is that kind of conversation generates morbidity, depression, anger, hostility. So normal people that come to me that used to, I used to have therapy sessions, you think personal therapy, they come to me and they got a problem, they will always have a problem. As long as the language they inherit from the culture has, I'm not as successful as I might be. I can't seem to learn as fast as George. As long as they have comparative values, they will always have problems. All the boys are carrying your books to school. Now that you're not as pretty, your sister came to town, they're carrying her books to school. And once you're brought up with prettiness and ugliness and less prettiness, and I'm getting older and I found a new wrinkle here, and I found a wrinkle around the view all the way down here, and I got 9 chins. And once you're caught up in those values, there is the emotional depression. You know, the years are rolling by so fast, like you want to go back to the old days. And the sanity of the future is looking to the future. Because as the computer gets bigger and wiser, it's more valuable. Let me see if I can explain this to you. A lot of people have difficulty in this kind of subject. They have great difficulty.